Hey guys, it's Jalen. Welcome or welcome back. I'm here today to share with you my update for the Friends Project Ban. This is a project that was created by Amy over at Curly Loves Beauty and Books, and it's all about the TV show Friends, which I just finished watching from start to finish again for like the sixth or seventh time or whatever. I still love that show. I know some people feel like it's, you know, not really relevant anymore, but I thoroughly enjoy it. Very nostalgic for me. Okay, let me share with you the two items I can roll out this month. I was working on six prompts, so I have two that are rolling out. The first one is for Rachel, a high maintenance product, and I rolled in the Ordinary's 100% L-ascorbic acid powder, and I rolled this in for 30 uses. I wasn't keeping track in my book, so I just used it for 2 months, basically. And this is how much is left in here. There's still a decent amount, but you can kind of see I'm about here now. So almost halfway, or about halfway done with this. I think I have two timeless vitamin C serums that I really want to get to. They're currently sitting in my fridge, and they're usually good. They're good for 6 months after you open it, or 3 months now, I can't remember. But I want to use those first before I go back to this. So that's the plan. I'm working on a vitamin C cream right now by Ole Henriksen. And once that's done, I'll probably pull out a vitamin C serum and I'll eventually get back to this. I didn't mind it. I don't know if it's as effective as the Timeless Serum is, but I didn't mind it. It was high maintenance, yes, because you have to take a little bit of this and put it in your hand and then put the serum in, a serum in, and then, you know, but I didn't mind it. Next one I can roll out is for the prompt Ross, an ancient or discontinued product in your collection. So I rolled in a Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Highlighter. This is in Berlin Girl Glow. Yeah, Berlin Girl Glow. And I rolled this in for 20 uses. I had 7 last month and I hit my 20 uses and I hit pan. Look at that huge pan I hit. I'm kind of shocked at how large that pan is now. I really do love this highlighter. It's lovely. You can't really see it on my hand. It's very, very light, but it's a beautiful, beautiful highlighter. I'm so glad I own this. So that is rolling out. All right, now for the items that I was still working on. The first one is for the prompt Monica, your cleanest product. So I rolled in this Kosas Revealer Skin Improving Foundation. I'll be honest, this isn't one I've been focusing on. I'm close though. Been working on some of my turn and burn stuff. So I think I'm close to being able to focus on this. We'll see. I'm hoping I'll have at least some use on it by the next month. I'm assuming this is an airless pump. It looks like it is. It doesn't look like I've used any of it, so I guess we'll see. Anyway, no progress on that. The next prompt is Phoebe, your most vivid colored product or packaging. I rolled in an eyeshadow by Touch of Glam Beauty. This is Aqua Me This. It's a gorgeous eyeshadow. I had 4 uses last month. I'm up to 7. Oh my goodness. It's so beautiful. It's beautiful. So yeah, 3 to go on this. The next prompt I have a product for is Chandler, a product with a funny name. So I rolled in a Bite Beauty lipstick that I made at the Bite Beauty Lip Lab. This is the Jackie 6. It's a funny name to me. And I rolled this in for 10 uses. Here's the shade. I had 1 use last month. I'm up to 5, right? Yeah, 5. There's the shade. It's beautiful. I love it. And the last prompt I was working on is Joey, a product with a food name, scent, or packaging. So I rolled in the Too Faced Primed and Peachy Cooling Matte Skin Perfecting Primer. This is a deluxe size. There are 20 mils in here. I don't love this primer, but I want to get it done and rolled out on my collection. So that is where I am now. I did roll this in to finish. It is part of my 100 colorful empties. So we're working on it. I kind of use this on days that I'm not filming, just in case it gives me like a dry skin. Like right now I used my retinol, and so I have some dry patches underneath my, like on the corners of my nose. So I don't want to use something like this because it's just going to make it even more dry. But working on it, it's like alternating. Every other day or every couple of days, I'll use it. Okay, so what I decided to do is, because this project is a 6-month project, it started in February and goes through August, I decided to go ahead and roll in the rest of the prompts because I want to make sure I get to all of them. So there are 10 prompts remaining, and so I have 10 items that I'm rolling in for those prompts. The first prompt is Ursula, a product you have two of. So I rolled in the Lancome Sills Booster XL. I have two of these. I picked a couple of Lancome mascara sets from Nordstrom last anniversary sale. So I have two of these and I want to finish this. This is probably gonna be in here 3 months. I will switch this out on July 1st. That's usually the time frame. I do it every 3 months. Next prompt is Gunther, a coffee scented or product named product. Named product, like coffee named product. So I went with a blush stick from Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is their stick blush in latte. So it does have a little brush on the end. I have not tried it, but I'm intrigued. And then here is the blush. This is really pretty. I don't have any blush like this that I'm working on right now, like color wise. So I thought this was a good addition to kind of what I'm rotating through. So I'm rolling this in for 10 uses. The next prompt is Janice, an annoying product to use. So I decided to roll in the Mae Lindstrom Skin, the Problem Solver. I have used one of these in the past and I think in my, like, either Beauty A to Z or 21 and 21 or something like that project. Anyway, so this, the reason why this is annoying to use, it's a lovely product, lovely mask, but basically you have to mix this powder with water, and then it's like a thick mud paste that you apply to your skin, and then because of the way it's made, I don't like to take it off over my sink. I like to take it off in the shower, so I really have to do it before I'm gonna get in the shower. So it's a lot of hassle. I think I got this free at one point because Mae Lindstrom does this thing. I want to say she does it in the summer, where if you spend a certain dollar amount, like $200 or $250, then you get a free item to go with your order. And it's, I mean, her stuff is usually like at least $100, like $80 to $100 minimum price. And I want to say this was a free item 1 year. So I had finished one, and of course I had a second one. And I want to show you this because I think this item I also got free with one of those deals a couple years prior. This is actually a beautiful bowl that she offers on her website. It's kind of, if I remember correctly, it's pricey. But she offers this on her website to mix this problem solver in. So I keep it like this. And I want to use this mask 10 times. I just want to get some use on it. I have a couple of other mud masks I'm working on, which is why I put a 10-use goal on this. No, I'm sorry, 5 uses. 5 uses. I put a 5-use goal on this because I've got like 2 or 3 other mud masks that I'm working on finishing. So I just want to open this up and get some use on it. Next prompt is Mr. Trigger, a product that fixes your look. So I couldn't not bring this in. This is Max Fix Plus spray. I have a full size. So I am going to go ahead and work on this, roll this into work on. I am working on a full size of my Mae Lindstrom facial spray. I may put this one on hold. Well, let me see. We'll see. I'm probably going to use this. No, you know what? Just to be safe, I am going to go ahead and work on the MAC Fix Plus as my primary spray. I may still use the Mario Badescu here and there, but I do want to finish one of these MAC Fix Pluses because I've got so many of them. Next prompt is Carol, a woman-owned brand, and I'm so excited to bring this in. I decided to roll in the Danessa Myricks Lightwork Volume 4 palette. This is a Transcendence palette. Transcendent, yeah. And I'm just rolling this in for 5 uses because this is a pricey palette. I was coveting it, and I just want to make sure I get some use on it. So here is the palette. Now, this shade here and this shade here are water-activated shades, and I actually do have some water here. I'm gonna try them. I haven't tried them yet. Wow. Oh, that's the first shade. I do feel like it's a little bit sheer, so I think going in with, oh, maybe not. Maybe I just need to pack my, let that water kind of, no, I feel like it is a little sheer. So I do think you need to maybe have a good base color underneath this. That is stunning. Holy moly. It's a little bit of work. A lot of work. That's okay. That's beautiful. I'm going to now try the other shade, the purple one. Hey! Hello. What are you doing? What's going on, buddy? Wow. Hey! There's the purpley shade. Wow, those are both really pretty. This is an interesting formula. I feel like I got them really wet. So I don't know if I need as much water as I put in there. And I'm probably just going to let this dry open like this. But I'll also swatch these like flaky shadows. They're kind of like an interesting cream formula. So those are the two like shades in the center. I feel like these could end up looking a little bit cakey on the eyes. So we'll have to see how that ends up working out. Because they do feel like you have to get them kind of warm under your fingers in order to use. But then there's, you know, these gorgeous multi-chromes. What? What? So yeah, I just want to get some use on this. I'm going to say use it 5 times and we'll go from there. So that is the Danessa Myricks Transcendence palette. Ziggy. He's a talker. Hi, baby. What are you doing? Hello. Hello. He is my baby. He's the baby of the group, and he follows me around everywhere. Hey. Okay. Say hi. Say hi. Say hi. Look at how cute for a hot second. Okay, the next prompt is Marcel, a product with animal pattern, packaging, or name. And I decided to roll in this Marc Jacobs Lamarck Lip Frost in Sugar Sugar. Here is the packaging of this one. I remember whenever I first pulled this out to use, I was like, I don't know about this lipstick. Like, it is so not a shade that I would normally go for. And then I tried it on and I liked it. Now, am I going to feel that same way now? I don't know. There's the shade there. If anything, it would be a good mixer. So we will see. I'm rolling this in for 10 uses. Next prompt is Frank Jr., a product that gets better as you use it. The only thing I can think of was mascara. So if you guys have any ideas, let me know down below. But I thought that I would roll in a deluxe size from Say. This is just, Mascara 101. That's what it looks like. So here is the packaging. This is part of a, what do they call it? Mascara certificate. That's what I want to say. I wanted to say scent certificate. That's not it. Mascara certificate that I have. And I think it's the last one that I have not tried. Right now, the number one from this list is the Ilia one. I haven't minded everything else. That one's just my favorite. So I want to try this one. It's the last one I haven't tried yet. So we're going to roll this one in to finish. The next prompt is Mr. Heckles, a product with pan. So I decided to go with a product that I've had in my collection a very long time, and I've had pan in a long time. I haven't touched it in a while. This is a MAC eyeshadow in Stars and Rockets. And I thought this would be a good shadow to bring in for the spring summer. So there is the shade. I'm going to actually put it up here on the upper part of my hand because I've run out of room. But there's the shade. I love this color. It's really pretty. It's not as glammy of like an eyeshadow that I wear now, but I still think it's really, really pretty. So we're going to roll that in for 10 uses. Next prompt is Emily, a product you tend to lose. And I decided to go with a cuticle pen. Now I have a cuticle pen in a different project and I have decided to keep it in my makeup, my lipstick bag. And it's this one here. And I have identified it by putting an X at the top, but I always lose these. Like I'll probably find one on my vanity at some point and be like, oh yeah, there's that one that I couldn't find. So anyway, I pulled this one out from my office and I went ahead and put an X on this one as well in a different color, but I'm rolling this into finish. I'm trying to get better about using cuticle oil more frequently and hand cream as well. So yeah, I want to empty this cuticle pen out. And the last prompt is a bonus prompt. It's Miss Chandler Bong, a product from a subscription. So I decided to roll in a perfume. This comes in my Skylar scent box. This is the scent Boardwalk Delight. It's a 10 mil roller ball. So I will decant this into an atomizer. And if you guys are ever looking for good atomizers, I think I always have the link to my favorite atomizers from Amazon that I've purchased. And those are linked in my Turn and Burn project description box. So I will link that up there so you can find it if you're interested. Anyway, I want to roll this in, because I got an email from Skylar and they're like, finally back in stock, something, something, everyone's favorite. And I'm like, okay, well, I have a mini of this. Let me see what all the fuss is about. This smells really lovely. It's a sweet scent. So I think it'll be good for spring, summer. So I'm rolling this in to finish. It'll be great to travel with as well. And I do have a couple of trips before this project ends where I can use it. So I'm rolling that in to finish. I think that is everything for this update. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you're doing well and staying safe. Please hit that subscribe button and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. For the first prompt, the product I rolled in for this is, let me do that all over again. So I decided to roll in a product from a scent subscription. So I decided to roll in a product from a scent certificate. Not scent certificate. My favorite Amazon atomized, the favorite, favorite. Oh, wow. Okay, bye.